A test was given to a group of students. The grades in gender are summarized below in the table. If one student is chosen at random from those who took the test, find the probability that the student was female given the student got an A. This is called conditional probability, where conditional probability is the probability of an event E sub 2 occurring given that an event E sub 1 has already occurred. And we do have this formula here for conditional probability, but let's see if we can determine this conditional probability just by analyzing the table first, and then we'll verify the results using our conditional probability formula. So we want to find the probability that a selected student would be female given they received an A on the test. So if we take a look at our table here, because we know the student already received an A, we can find all the information we need from this first column. Notice how there were a total of 16 A students, and of those A students, 9 of them were female. So if we already know the student received an A, the probability of selecting a female student given the student received an A would be equal to 9/16. The total number of outcomes is 16 because we know they already received an A. The favorable number of outcomes is 9, the number of females that received an A. This is our conditional probability. Let's also write this as a decimal and a percentage. 9 divided by 16 is equal to 0.5625. Which is a percent would be 56.25%. Now let's verify this probability using our conditional probability formula. We would have the probability of a female given an A grade is equal to this fraction here, where we have the probability of E sub 2 and E sub 1, where the probability of a female and an A divided by the probability of E sub 1, which in our case would be the probability of receiving an A. So going back to our table, the probability of selecting one student and that student being female and receiving an A, notice how there's a total of 9 female students that received an A out of the total class of 75. So the probability of selecting one student and that student being female and receiving an A would be 9/75 divided by selecting one student from the class and the probability of that student receiving an A. Notice how there were a total of 16 students that received an A out of the class of 75 students, and therefore the probability of selecting a student that received an A would be 16/75. Remember, this fraction bar means division, so we can write this as 9/75 divided by 16/75, which is equal to 9/75 times the reciprocal of 75/16. And notice how the 75s simplify to 1, leaving us with the probability that we found above as 9/16. Because we have this nice table that breaks down all the information for us, we can find this conditional probability straight from the table and not have to use this formula. But sometimes this formula is very helpful.